Thanks for waiting 16 years.
What about us waiting 16 years?
It's of a brave young highwayman, the story we will tell. His name was Willie Brennan, and in Ireland he did dwell. 'Twas on the Kilworth Mountains he commenced his wild career, and many a well-paid nobleman before him shook with fear. And it's Brennan on the moor, Brennan on the moor, bold, brave and undaunted was young Brennan on the moor. One day upon the highway as Willie he went down, he met the mayor of Cashel a mile outside the town. The mayor he knew his features, and he said, young man, says he, your name is Willie Brennan, you must come along with me. And it's Brennan on the moor, Brennan on the moor, bold, brave and undaunted was young Brennan on the moor. Brennan's wife had gone to town for visions gone to buy, and when she saw her Willie she commenced to weep and cry. She said, hand to me that tenpenny, and as soon as Willie spoke she handed him a blunderbuss from underneath her cloak. Hurry up, Brennan on the moor, Brennan on the moor, bold, brave and undaunted was young Brennan on the moor. Now with this loaded blunderbuss the truth I will unfold. He made a bear to tremble, loved him off his gold. £100 was offered for his apprehension there, so he with horse and saddle to the mountains did repair. Did young Brennan on the moor, Brennan on the moor, bold, brave and undaunted was young Brennan on the moor. Now Brennan been an outlaw upon the mountains high, with cavalry and infantry to take a day to try. He loved them to soar until at last was said by a false hearted woman he was cruelly betrayed. Was young Brennan on the moor, Brennan on the moor, bold, brave and undaunted was young Brennan on the moor. They took Brennan to the crossroads and there he hung and died, but still they say that in the night they'll soon to see him lie. They see him with his brown nose all in the midnight chill, as all along the King's Highway Willie Brennan still. And it's Brennan on the moor, Brennan on the moor, bold, brave and undaunted was young Brennan on the moor.
Thank you. Thank you. And as you may have noticed, that song was Brennan on the Moor. He was an outlaw from County Tipperary. And here's another outlaw from County Tipperary over here, Liam Clancy.
Nice to be back.
And his brother, Tom. And our Emperor of South Armagh, Tommy Mick. And I'm their father, Paddy Clancy.
In the year of the Lord, 1806, we set sail from the whole Cape Horn. And we were sailing away with a cargo of bricks for the Grand City Hall in New York. We didn't have a it was rigged for a laugh, and how the trade winds drove her. She had 20 easy masts, and she stood several blasts, and they called for the Irish girl.
Ooh,
we had Barney McGee from the banks of the Lee, we had Hogan
from County Tyrone. And we had Johnny McGurk, who was scared stiff of a warpath, the chap from Westmead named Malone. We had Slur O'Toole, who was drunk as a rule, and fighting Bill Tracy from Dover. And your man McMahon, from the banks of the Ban, was the skipper on the Irish Rover. We had 1 million bags of the best Sligo rags, we had 2 million barrels of bone. And we had 3 million bales of our nanny goat's tails, we had 4 million barrels of stone. We had 5 million hogs, I had 6 million dogs, and 7 million barrels of porter. We had 8 million sight of our blind horses' height in the hold of the Irish Rover. We had sailed 7 years when the measles broke out, our ship lost her way in a fog. And the whale of a crew was reduced down to two, 'twas myself and the captain down dog. Well, the ship's of a rock, oh Lord, what a shock, and nearly tumbled over, turned 9 times around, and the poor old dog was drowned.
With our nets and gear, we're faring on the wild and wasteful ocean. It's out there on the deep that we harvest and reap our bread. As we hunt the bonny shoals of herring, it was on a fair and a pleasant day, the Yarmouth Harbour I was faring, as a cabin boy on a sailing lubber, for to hunt the bonny shoals of herring. Oh, we left the home grounds in the month of June, and for Canny Shields we soon were bearing, with 100 grand silver garments that we taken from the shoals of herring. Now the work was hard and the hours were long, and the treatment sure it took some bearing, and I used to sleep standing on my feet, and I dream about the shoals of herring. Fisherman, and you're learning all about seafaring, that your education's tracks of navigation, as you hunt the bonny shoals of herring. In the stormy seas and in the living gales, I earned the gear that I was wearing, sailed 10,000 fishes as we hunted for the shoals of herring. And it's night and day we're faring, come winter wave or winter gale,
sweating our coat, growing up, growing old, are dying. As we hunt the bunny shows of
a young man who felt very insignificant in life. He had a terrible inferiority complex, and he was socially very awkward. Wherever he was, the action was always somewhere else. And he never felt the center of attraction until he died, and at his own wake, and everybody gathered around. And he thought to himself, isn't it grand, boys, to be bloody well dead?
Look at the coffin with golden handles. Isn't it grand, boys, to be bloody well dead? Let's not have a sniffle. Let's have a bloody good cry. And always remember, the longer you live, the sooner you'll bloody well die.
Look at the mourner, bloody great hypocrites. Isn't it grand, boys, to be bloody well dead?
Let's not have a sniff. Let's have a bloody good cry. And always remember, the longer you live, the sooner you'll bloody well die.
Look at the flowers, all bloody withered. Isn't it grand, boy, to be bloody?
Let's not have a sniffle. Let's have a bloody good cry. And always remember, the longer you live, the sooner you'll bloody well die.
Look at the preacher, bloody sanctimonious. Isn't it grand, boys, to be bloody well dead?
Let's not have a sniffle. Let's have a bloody good cry.
Let's hear it.
And always remember, the longer you live, the sooner you'll bloody well die.
Look at the widow,
bloody great female. Isn't it grand, boys, to be bloody well dead? Let's not have a sniffle. Let's have a bloody good cry. And always remember, the longer you live, the sooner you'll bloody.
My hair is so like home, but that's all right till I go home. She is handsome, she is witty, she is the belle of at Belfast City. She is a courting 1, 2, 3. Please will you tell me who is he? Albert Mooney says he loves her. All the boys are fighting for. They're up at the door, they ring the bell. Said, oh my true love, are you well? Out she comes as white as snow, rings on her fingers, bells on her toes. Oh, Johnny Marie says she'll die if she doesn't get the fellow with the Roman knife.
Let the wind and the rain and the hail blow high, and the snow come travelling from the sky. She's as nice as apple pie, she'll get her own lad by and by.
When she gets a lad of her own, she won't tell a ma when she comes home. Let them all come as they will, but it's Albert Mooney she loves day. And now when I go home, the boys won't leave the girls alone. They pull my hair, the show might come, well that's all right till I go home. She's handsome, she is pretty, she is the belle of Belfast City. She is a courting 1, 2, 3, please will you tell me who is she? Oh, Albert Mooney said she loves her, all the boys are fighting for her. Rap at the door, they ring at the bell, saying, oh my true love, are you well? Out she comes as white as snow, rings on her fingers, bells on her toes. Oh, Johnny Marie says she'll die if she doesn't get the fellow with the Roman knife. Let them all come as they will, for as Albert Mooney she loves still. In the merry month of June, from me home I started, left the girls a tomb. Nearly broken hearted, saluted father dear. Kissed me darling mother, drank a pint of beer. Me grief and tears to smother, then up to reap the corn. Leave where I was born, with a stout black thorn to banish ghosts and goblins. A brand new pair of brogues, rattling o'er the box and frightening all the dogs. On the rocky road to Dublin, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Put the hair and turn her down the rocky road, and all the way to Dublin, whack for Lundy Rock.
In Mullingar Garden night, I rested late, so weary, started by daylight. My spirits glide and airy, took a drop of the pure. Keep my heart from sinking, that's the Paddy's cure. Whenever he's on for drinking, to see the lassie smile, laughing all the while at my curious strength, and sent your heart to bubble and ask if I was hired. Wages I required till I was nearly tired of the rocky road to Dublin.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Hunt the hare and turn her down the rocky road, and all the way to Dublin, whack for Lundy Rock. In Dublin next arrived, I thought it such a pity to be so soon deprived of view of that fine city. Well, then I took a stroll all among the quality, but through it was stolen in a neat locality. Something crossed my mind when I looked behind, no button could I find. A pot, my stick, a wobbling inquired for the road. Then they cannot broke one much more on the rocky road to Dublin.
Now 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Put the hair and turn her down the rocky road, and all the way to Dublin, whack for Lundy Rock.
From there I got away, my spirits never fail, and landed on the quay just as the ship was sailing. The captain at me roared, said that no room had he, when I jumped aboard a cabin found for Paddy. Down among the pigs, played some folly rigs, danced some hearty jigs, the water round me bubble, and when a folly head, wished myself was dead or better far instead. On the rocky road to Dublin,
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Hunt the hare and turn her down the rocky road, and all the way to Dublin, back for Lundy Rock. The boys of Liverpool, when we safely landed, called myself a fool. I could no longer stand it, blood began to boil. Temper I was losing, poor old Aaron's Isle. They began abusing around his house as I shall lay the island high. Galway boys were nigh, and so I was hobbling with a loud array. Joining in the affray, we quickly tailed away. For the rocky road to Dublin, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Hunt the hare and turn her down the rocky road, and all the way to Dublin, white for Lundy Rock.
He stumbled home from Clifton Fair with drunken song and cheeks aglow. Yet there was something in his air that told of kingship long ago. I turned and inly burned with grief that one so high should fall so low. But he plucked a flower and sniffed its scent and waved it toward the sunset sky. Some old sweet rapture through him went and kindled in his blood shot eye. I sighed and inly cried for joy that one so low should rise so high. I wish I was in Carrickfergus, only for nights in Ballygran. I would swim over the deepest ocean, the deepest ocean, my love to find. But the sea is wide and I can't swim over, and neither have I wings to fly. I wish I could meet a handsome boatman to ferry me over to my love and die. Ah, but in Kilkenny it is reported they have marble stones there as black as ink, with gold and silver I did support her. But I'll sing no more until I get a drink.
I'm drunk today, and I'm seldom sober. A handsome rover from town to town.
Ah, but I'm sick. My days are numbered. Come all you young men and lay me down.
Fond of the grub, he's fond of the booze. Fella from Katy, he would drink it out of anything, a smelly welly or a dirty mug or an oil can, anything he could get his hands on, as long as it was booze. Somebody threw a petrol bomb into a pub one night and he drank it. He went on the tear one time. For about 4 or 5 days he was missing, and they found him in Belfast one morning and the head pumping off him. He says, who in the name of God said two heads was better than one? And he's walking along the footpath and he wanted to get to the far side and he stepped off. And as he did so, a car came along and brushed against him and he fell down. And he was about to get up and go on about his business, but he looked up from where he was lying in the gutter and he saw a lovely shiny front on the car, an RR on the top of her, a Rolls Royce. We decided he'd lay where he was. Started shouting, my back's broke, my back. Driver got out, put him into the car, took him off to the hospital. They examined him for 17 hours and they couldn't find a damn thing wrong with him. He kept roaring and shouting about the back. They kept him in for 3 months and eventually they let him out in a wheelchair, still complaining about the back. About 7 or 8 weeks after he got out, there was a big law case about this accident in Armagh. And after deliberating for 19 days, they awarded him £83,000. He's coming down out of the courthouse in Armagh in the wheelchair. This fellow walked over and said, excuse me for a minute. I'm an investigator for the insurance company. And you fooled the doctors and you fooled the lawyers and you fooled the police and you fooled the general public, but you didn't fool me for a second. And for every minute you're alive and every breath you breathe, there's going to be one of my men looking down your throat. Fair enough, says this neighbour of mine. But I hope the fella you're watching me tomorrow morning is a Catholic, because I'm going down to the airport in Belfast and I'm going to get on an aeroplane and I land in Lourdes and I won't be there 10 minutes till I've seen the greatest miracle that's happened in 100 years. Well, I'm going to sing you a song about a fella that wouldn't know Lourdes if he walked over it barefooted. In a mean abode on the Shankill Road lived a man named William Bloat. And he had a wife, the bane of his life, who always got his goat. And one day at dawn with her nightdress on, he slit her bloody throat. With a razor gash, he settled her hash. Ah, never was crime so quick. But the steady drip on the pillow slip of her life's blood made him sick. And the pool of gore on the bedroom floor grew clotted and cold and thick. Ah, but he was glad he had done what he had, as she lay there stiff and still. Till suddenly of the angry law filled his soul with an awful chill. And to finish the fun so well begun, he decided himself to kill. Well, he took the sheet from his wife's cold feet and he twisted it into a rope. And he hanged himself from the pantry shelf. 'Twas an easy end, let's hope. With his dying breath in the jaws of death, he solemnly cursed the Pope. But the strangest turn of the whole concern is only just beginning. He went to hell, but his wife got well, and she's still alive and sinning. For the razor blade was British made, but the rope was Belfast linen.
You blackguard, you.
Oh, wet me whack, fall the dough, fall the diddly idly.
Oh, wet me whack, fall the dough, fall the diddly
idly. As I roved out through Galway town to seek for recreation, on the 17th of August, we might be elevated. There was multitudes assembled with their tickets at the station. The eyes began to dazzle and I going to see the races. With me whack, fall the dough, fall the diddly-idly. It's there you'll see confectioners with sugar sticks and dainties, and lozenges and oranges and lemonade and raisins, and gingerbread and spices to accommodate the ladies, and a big proveen for threepence to be picking while you're able.
With me whack, fall the dough, fall the diddly-idly.
You all know what the crew beans are, of course.
pig's feet. They were the original fast food of Ireland. They were fast before they were cooked, and they were fast after it, by God. They were a great standby at the races. We used to go to the races down the Strand in Tramore, and when crew beans had been rolled around in the sand for a little while, there was a great crunch off them. We had the back of your teeth for a week. We always boiled them up for about 11 hours. I don't know why we call them fast food. In very salty water. We always left a little bit of the hair on them, about an inch for decoration. And a little bit of the dirt in between the two toes for flavoring.
Talking about roughage.
And for some mysterious reason, they were always served up in last week's newspaper. I don't know why that was. But it was great because the headlines used to stick to the back of the grease, you know. It was very educational. There was reading and eating in them. It was great. It's there you'll see the pipers and the fiddlers competing, and the nimble-footed dancers, and they tripping on the daisies. There was others frying cigars and lights and bills for all the races, with the colours of the jockeys and the price and horses' ages. Whip they whack, all the dough, all the dilly-dilly. It's there you'll see the jockeys, and they mounted on so stately, the blue, the pink, the orange and green, the emblem of our nation. When the bell was rung for starting, all the horses seemed impatient. I thought they never stood on ground, their speed was so amazing. When they whack, while the dough, while the diddly-idle-ay. There was half a million people there of all denominations, the Catholic, the Protestant, the Jew and Presbyterian. There was yet no animosity, no mother or persuasion, but fortune, hospitality, it keeps and fresh acquaintance. Whip me whack, fall the dough, fall the diddly-idly. And whip me whack, fall the dough, fall the diddly-idly.
Join us in a jug of punch.
One pleasant evening in the month of June, as I was sitting with my glass and spoon, a small bird sat on an ivy punch, and the song he sang was the jug of punch. Toor-a-loor-a-loo, toor-a-loor-a-lay, toor-a-loor-a-loo, toor-a-loor-a-lay. A small bird sat on an ivy bunch, and the song he sang was the
What more diversion can a man desire than to sit him down by a stump-top fire? Upon his knee a pretty wench, aye, and on the table a jug of punch.
Do-ra-lo-ra-lo, do-ra-lo-ra-lay, do-ra-lo-ra-lo, do-ra-lo-ra-lay. Upon his knee a pretty wench, aye, and on the table a jug of punch.
Let the doctors come with all their art, they'll make no impression upon my heart. Even the cripple forgets his punch when he's snug outside of a jug of punch.
And toodaloo-la-loo, toodaloo-la-lay, toodaloo-la-loo, toodaloo-la-lay. Even the cripple forgets his punch when he's snug outside of a jug of punch.
And if I get drunk, well, the money's me own. And them don't like me, they can leave me alone.
Tell him, Paddy.
I'll chun me fiddle, and I'll rosin me bow. And I'll be welcome wherever I go.
No, never, no more. Well, hardly ever.
And it's no, nay, never. No, nay, never, no more. But I play the wild rover. No, never, no more. I've been a wild rover for many years a year. Now I'm returning with gold in great store, and I never will play the wild rover no. And it's no, nay, never. No, nay, never, no more. But I play the wild rover. No, never, no more.
I went in to an alehouse where I used to frequent, and I told the landlady me money was spent. I asked her for credit, she answered me nay. Such a custom as yours I can get any day.
And it's no
I took sovereigns bright, and the landlady's eyes opened wide with delight. She said, I have whiskey and wines of the best, and the words that I said, Lim, were only in jest.
I
and it's not a
pardon their prodigal son, and if they'll caress me as oft times before, then I never will play the wild rover no more. And it's no, nay, never, no, nay, never, no more, but I play the wild rover. No, never, no more.
What's more like you mean it?
And it's no, nay, never. No, nay, never, no more. But I play the wild rover. No, never, no
says the summertime is coming, the trees are sweetly blooming, and the wild mountain thyme grows around the blooming heather. Will you go, lassie? Go.
I will, she said, I will.
Oh, the summertime is coming, and the trees are sweet blooming, and the wild mountain thyme grows around the blooming heather. Will you go, lassie, go?
Rise it.
And we'll all go together to pluck wild mountain thyme all around the blooming heather. Will you go, lassie, go?
I will build my love a bower near yon pure crystal fountain, and on it I will pile all the flowers o'er the mountain. Will you go, lassie?
Wild mountain thyme all around the blooming heather. Will you go, lassie, go?
If my true love she were gone, I would choose find another where wild mountain thyme grows around the blooming heather. Will you go, lassie, go?
And we'll all go to pluck wild
time. All around the glowing heaven, will you go, lassie?
It's too nice to stop here. Let's start from the beginning. The summertime is coming.
Oh, the summertime is coming.
And the trees are sweetly blooming.
And the trees are sweetly blooming.
And the wild mountain time.
And the wild mountain time
grows around the blooming heather.
Grows around the blooming heather.
Will you go, lassie?
Will you go, lassie?
We'll all go together.
And we'll all go together. All around the blooming heather, will you go, lassie, go?
We're going to leave you and love you with a song. You don't have to sing the chorus. You shout it at the top of your voice. It says, "Fine Gary, you are."
Fare thee well, my lovely Dinah, a thousand times with you. For we're born away from the holy ground that the girls we all love through. We will sail the salt sea over, and we'll return for shore to see again the girls we love and the holy ground once more. You're the girl I do adore, and still I live in hopes to see the holy ground once more. And now the storm is raging, and we are far from shore. The good old ship is tossed about, and the rigging is all fore. And the secrets of my mind, my love, you're the girl I do.